Hello again. Welcome to the second beginning. I'm actually contemplating if I should play the game on Veteran, since I've never finished the game, and I do believe that I always played on Rookie. I even used some cheats. But, yeah, let's keep it on Veteran. It's gonna retain some of the atmosphere of desperation.
Military support as we can muster. Remember, the Alliance is with you. Good luck. You will need it.
Okay, so what I did before was probably a mistake. Even though, if he stays here, he's gonna get surrounded. I need to use those attack points while I still have them. And, Yeah. And I'm actually gonna move those units, even though they have the high ground and I should use it. I'm gonna move them to him. What's their range? Yeah, this means that I need to move one block and I could attack them. However, the high ground gives you better range, which basically means that this sloped ground doesn't count now. So if I stand on it, my range will be still the same and I will have one less attack. However, I still need to do it. You see, I can't reach them. I have to go all the way down. So I had to make two steps to gain 1 point of range. And that's the importance of the high ground, because when you are standing up on the high ground, the enemy has to use their action points to get to you and before they can actually attack you. The light infantry, I have to stay with them on top, because yeah, it's very easy to just lose them. They can't attack now, but they're very weak. Their attack is just 9, whereas Captain Alexander has the attack 15, so yeah. But first, I'm not actually gonna use him, because I know that there are more units hidden and they will come out. First, I want to use the Rangers, because they're weaker. And I want to keep the strongest units, I want to use them later in the round to be more decisive. Yeah, I shouldn't be trying to pronounce this correctly. Okay, I harmed them a bit. Cool. Now I've kept 2 points of attack. Now I still have the chance to get the counter attack. He has Captain Alexander has the largest view, even larger than the Rangers, the scout units, so it's possible for him to get a counterattack. It's still possible even now. Okay, he didn't have it, so I probably should have moved. Now, yeah, I'll start from the back. I'll start attacking the wolves. They are the most dangerous. This was a miss. That's great. I want to finish them off. Oh no. I probably don't want to finish them off. That would be a waste. Yeah, let's hope for the best. I was very lucky, because the unharmed orcs missed all their shots and they swapped a little bit. It was failed from the AI. Now I want to kill the wolves with the other guys, because all of the units are gaining the experience. You can see down here on the bottom, every shot they do, if they don't miss, they get experience. But they get even more experience if they kill someone. It doesn't matter how much health the unit has left, there is a base amount of damage of experience that you're gonna get for killing. If I could possibly level up someone, it's very valuable because immediately their attack will increase. They might even get an extra attack, but they will need more levels for that. Let's kill the wolves. You can see how the experience bar jumped. So they're not gonna finish them off in one shot. Waiting. But I'll actually try the wolves. Oh, fuck. Yeah, they're almost leveled up. But now I really have to take care of those guys. Yeah, this is good. This is good. Now he's gonna survive the initial attack. And I'm actually glad that I'm attacking him, because he, as a single unit, can heal up to full health. Well, not in the one round, but as long as the whole bar is green or orange, all of the units can heal up. Usually when they attack our men, they will kill some of them and wound more. So even when I heal them up, they will be weaker. I'll try now to kill those. Okay, let's get experience points to these guys. Now I to end the turn. As far as I know, this was the end of the initial attack. Now I healed him up completely. And now I can start actually doing something. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna save. And on the hard difficulty, you have 6 saves for the mission. I'm gonna use it. And it's just one position. There's no list of saves. Let's scout. Waiting. And now I will cluster them together and move as a single unit. Yeah. And what you want to do in this game usually is dig a hole, hide in it, and hope that the enemy will find you when you're dug in on a high ground. Okay, now as they stepped on the hill, they get a nice view of the surroundings, and we found out another unit. Now after a while, when you know where the units actually are roughly, it's important not to discover them and capture them in the middle of the fight, because as you can see, their bars are a little bit darker. It actually means that I won't be able to move them until next round. And that can quite often mean that they will get killed before I can even use them. Okay. Let's get the captain up. And now I can use them. And I really want to get all of the guys together. Okay. Now, as you can see, those guys are standing here. And the hill is blocking their view. So if there's someone, a whole army standing there, even though they would be close, they couldn't shoot at them. So that's why I'm putting my strongest units on the slopes, because they can just shoot everywhere. Receiving. And since the captain has actually, even though he's the most important unit, he has the most action points. He's good for scouting. I will show you. They can get they can dug in. They can dig in. Yeah. It's based on their level, how quickly they're starting to dig in. And it's represented by those yellow dots. And how the enemy can get that as well. How that works is that if he gets attacked now, it will very probably just take away some of the yellow dots and it won't harm him. So it's like a shield. It's, yeah, he just dug in. It's a foxhole and they have to break it first to get to him. And that's very important. It's because in this game, you basically want to be on the defensive all the time because you are getting swarmed by zones of enemy. However, I need to scout with him. Because I need to get somewhere. He's good because he can scout, but he can also run away. And those guys are just chilling there and actually gaining a little bit of extra defense, so if they got jumped now they will have higher chance. Now I found some orcs. I think if I started to, because it's quite possible that they didn't see me, if I shoot at them all of the units here will be alerted and there's probably more and they will come after me and just chop me to pieces. So what I want to do is attack them. That was a very nice attack. Half of them are dead. But now I want to run. Because I have a lot of action points. I can run away from them. But I have alerted them. And the trees are also cover. Especially against the shooting units. But my guys, no. Are almost in range. So yeah, I'm gonna get him back to the hill. Now if they go into this fog of war and come out of the trees, they can actually get the counter attack. Yeah. This is really important. Because you just used, I just noticed that there is, in the US version, there's a blood remaining on the floor where I killed units. That's nice. Now I used the action points that I couldn't otherwise use because I didn't use them in the last round. And they got the experience, they got a new level. And the first level, I remember, is that they basically get plus one to all the stats, I think. So now they have attack 11, not 10. It might not sound as much, but it's quite important. Now I'm gonna wait several more rounds. It's a game of waiting. Oh yeah, I didn't want to move them. Because when they move, they lose the foxhole. Okay. There might have been some units that were following them but stopped. If he sees, if I send him far away and he sees something, he will stop and call it out. Oh, sure. So now I am divided. My commander is in a different place. I think there's more units hidden here somewhere. And I got attacked. Yeah, let's try to level those guys up as much as I can. Oh, damn. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. Oh, I can still use those guys, that's cool. You don't want to lose a single possibility to attack if they're swarming you.
Waiting.
Okay, I harmed them a little bit. I didn't even touch the wolf, so I have to attack them. The rangers will be probably attacked, and they're not dug in. And they were not, they're not digging in now because they were attacking. I'm really not out of the harm's way. Oh, yeah, that's good. There's more. That's not good. I need to get back with the captain to be able to get into the fight. It's just one of them wounded, so that basically means that I didn't lose anyone yet. And you could see how the light infantry actually tanked the attack. The wolves are still standing on the slope, but I can already reach them because... Yeah, they missed. I don't actually use... I don't buy light infantry afterwards because they're just useless. Those orcs might come up and actually reach me and attack me. I will move them, since they don't have cover anyway. Yeah, die. They screamed, but it still was soaked up. But now it wouldn't be, not anymore. But now, if I stand the captain here, I can't reach them. That's really bad. Just to reach them now, I would have to go all the way here, actually. And I will keep him here, because there might be more nasties in the forest. And I don't want to get attacked when I can't defend myself. Alright. Let's try to finish those off. Yes, I got another level. And now they have attack level 10. Actually, yeah. Now we can compare, yeah, they got plus one to everything, including the armor, so, yeah. Leveling it up is crucially important here. Now, I could heal those guys up, but those orcs are gonna kill someone, so I will use those attacks. Okay. I hate those situations because they don't really do anything. Yeah, and they killed someone, but they don't really do anything, but they will take the cover away. Yeah, I wanted to level them up at least. Now, I'll wait and heal up the rest of the guys. One of them got killed. There's like five orcs that were left, because the orcs and light infantry represent 100 soldiers. They managed to kill one and wound the other two. Rangers are just 20 of those guys, and which means that, yeah, it's quite possible that none of them will get killed. Okay. We didn't get very far. I'm gonna save anyway. I know that on one play, there's probably more of units for me to capture. And I don't really want to leave this spot. Okay, get back. Because it's a nice high ground, it's too up. But I need to scout a bit. There might be more units for me to save here somewhere. I think I remember that actually there are. And they will be attacked when I... Oh, damn. Okay. Another run. Since that was quite close, it's possible that they saw me. But now, yeah.
Waiting.
Let's stop being careful. And move them together. I don't want to go through the forest. Because my only advantage is that I have ranged weapons. When it comes to close combat, well, you saw it. You get chopped to pieces.
Waiting.
So, now I'm gonna
Receiving.
Set them up on this hill, and I will use the captain again to provoke them to come at me. I don't know what they're doing there. It's quite possible that they're moving, and then some of the units are stationary, some of the units are prepared to be moving. This is a good way to climb up, because I can sneak up on them and see a little bit more before I get discovered. Have better range, have the high ground advantage, and actually be able to attack straight away.
Contact.
You can see that they were digging in as well. There might be light infantry there. If I discover them now, the orcs will just kill them. So now I want to shoot them. So you can see that I didn't really do much. I harmed 11, killed some, and now I have to run. But my units are on the hill, and they are counterattacking. You can see that those that are lighter colors, they will participate into this in this counterattack, and they are just switching turns.
Waiting.
Now I want to use them, preferably. And gain as much experience as I can. Yeah, they're out of range now. No, I'm not gonna do that. They can't reach me. Not to attack me, they can come close. The opponent fire is... In Czech, it was just labeled as counterattack. It's really important. It's like getting an extra turn to their disadvantage. They can get it as well. And once they get ranged units, it's gonna become pretty dangerous. Seems like that's it. It was just two units of orcs. Nothing really big. So now I can finally discover the whole place. Get a better view. Maybe, hopefully, save someone. I thought that there was someone in this area. No, probably not. This is the edge of the map. Okay, there's no one here. I need to... Yeah, You will crisscross the whole map. Don't count with some shorter route. There will be a river or something. It will just force you to kill everything. Okay, so there is no one to be saved. So I'm moving back, always moving and the last unit that you used will be selected on the next round. You can see that even though that I stepped down further away from them, I don't see more ground.
Perceiving.
Okay.
Perceiving.
I'm leaving the defensive position and exposing myself.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Yeah, cool. So I exposed myself and what I'm gonna do is, yeah, no, I want to get away. Oh, cool.
Perceiving.
Not that many of them, at least not yet. Oh, that's cool. Let's wait a few rounds. Okay.
Yeah.
Seems like it was a single unit. Which is weird. I can see down here. Do you see how long? I still don't see. There could be an army here.
Perceiving.
Luckily there was no one.
Waiting.
I want to move in the open ground if possible. The forest is really dangerous. If you get jumped in the forest, you lose all your range advantage and it gets messy. I'm waiting here, even though the house is blocking the range of the units. It's still, it can also block the orcs, so they can't like overwhelm me. Okay.
Perceiving. Yeah.
Let's move to that platform.
Perceiving.
It's good to start moving with the faster moving units because the slower ones are not gonna block you.
Perceiving. Waiting. Perceiving.
Oh, cool. So orcs hidden there.
Perceiving.
Now they saw me. And I can't attack them with those guys. I would have to move in here or down, all the way down here to attack them. So that's not a very good position. I wouldn't have that much attacks while I was moving, and I would be pretty close to them. They didn't see me.
Contact.
Let's provoke them. Usually, if you do one step, one shot, you will still have. Enough action points to move one step back or downhill, because that uses less action points. Now they saw me, but now they're in danger of counter attack. Yeah, even though they will probably reach me, they still get some beating and they will be weakened before they can reach me. It's just all about weakening them before they can get to you. Now I'll wait a bit. There can be units in the area that had the shots and will come after me. Okay. The edge of the map. I will just check quickly with the captain if there's someone here. Someone I could save. I'm pretty sure there's no enemy unit. The obstacles do make the traveling harder, so if I would go to the rocks and try to walk on the rocks, I would lose the action points much faster. I think it works with vehicles anyway. I'm not sure if it works with the infantry. It doesn't really make sense to do, but with the vehicles, they travel faster on the roads. So you want to keep using the roads. With infantry, you just want to keep avoid dangerous areas. Okay. Waiting. Now I have to move in because now I'm in the forest. Waiting. And I'm losing the range. Waiting. That means that I really want to be moving all of them together so they can at least cover each other a little bit. There is possibility that I will meet enemy units in the forest, and then it's just a mess. Oh yeah, and you can't drive. The infantry units have the actual advantage of using the forest. They can walk through the forest. Vehicles can't. They have to drive around. You can also see that I don't really scout while I'm here. It's getting scary because this whole area could be filled with orcs. I want to get out of the forest as far as quickly as possible. But I know... I see something now. When I step away from the forest, I get a little bit of better view. I know there is actually a hidden fence here. Somewhere. Oh, there it is. Waiting. And that's really important. Because behind this fence is actually one of the strongest infantry units that's not artillery. And that's commandos. I have to shoot this fence there. Some of the buildings you see here, they're actually nice models. It's kind of typical 90s village architecture. But this building, it can be destroyed. It's a destructible environment, some of it. Now, you can see down here, it's a palisade, and it has 30% health and defense 4. This is not much, but I'm shooting it with M16. So you can imagine that half of the shots won't do anything, and those that actually hit it won't do much as well. I don't think I picked a good... yeah. The wall has fallen, the commandos are free and ready to strike. And that's really important, because it's not only commandos that actually have explosives. They have rifle grenades they can use. But they have 4 attacks, lot of action points, it's 20 of them. They're better than rangers. I don't buy rangers afterwards, even though that you can could see that how better they are compared to the light infantry. But the commandos are the best. They can take on the heavy units. You can see that their attack against the heavy units is 12. Rangers have 5. Light infantry has 6. Rangers are actually poor against armored anything. And those guys are already leveled up. They are level 5. Okay. And okay, now I actually think, because those markings here usually represent units that are just for the mission. Sometimes you get like trucks that you need to escort to some place, and they just appear on the beginning of the map. And they don't continue with you. So I think what that could mean that I actually will lose those guys, that they don't really matter for the mission. But those commandos don't have it. Those are mine, I will keep them. I think it is because this sort of an Easter egg. Because you need to find them in the forest, which is difficult to navigate. You have to free them. You need to break the wall to see them. I could go around and I couldn't see in. And yeah, that's nice. You can see. that those guys mean business. Yes. Nice. That's the most important addition to my army. It's they easily doubled my power, my overall power. Might be a good time to save. For a first mission, before you can even look at the game, it's quite difficult, and the map is quite big. It takes time. I need to get out of this forest. Yeah, there is a high ground. I need to approach carefully. I'm starting to hear some water. I remember that there is like a bridge somewhere. Waiting. Okay. Yes. Let's scout around a bit.
Receiving. Problems. Waiting.
Hey, let's check the information about the commandos. Yeah, they have nice red berets. Yeah, special forces. Yeah. Comprise. SAS, Fallen Legion, Green Berets. And Spetsnaz as well. Cool!
Yeah.
Of course they're here. And they can come through the forest. I think if they didn't see me, which I hope they didn't, I will wait for my guys to dig in a bit. You can see that the commanders are already dug in. The 6 is the maximum because they have high level. Those guys are struggling, but they're already dug in. They're really powerful.
Contact.
And those guys dug in as well, so I missed. Now, I'm gonna move here because they saw me standing here shooting at them, but now they don't see me, and the AI works that they don't actually know that I went down here, so they will go here, and if they see me then they might change their plans and attack the captain. So I use him as a bait. Yeah, I like the sound of their guns, and you could see that, yeah. They're better. Oh, sure. And they're coming through the forest. So it's good that I'm dug in. Now, who can attack them? The light infantry. Those guys can't. Those guys can't. Because, yeah, they sort of... This tree, from this angle, this tree is already blocking them. And for this angle, this tree is blocking them. So it's just this unit that can attack. So you see how dangerous it is. They're already close, and it's just one unit that can attack them. So they can just start attacking.
Waiting.
And sure enough, even through the foxhole, they did wound some of my guys. Yeah. Yeah, let's just wreck them with... If I can resolve this situation without using the wounded units, like right now, that's what I want to do. Because now I can heal them. I didn't lose the foxhole. And I'm back where I started. I'll actually move. I'll wait, not move. I'll wait. Yeah, now I'll scout a little bit more. This is a fairly good position. I want to scout this area because there might be enemy units, there might be friendlies. Okay, wolves. Now I'm pretty close to the wolves. They dug in. I'm pretty sure they saw me. I'm not gonna shoot them because that costs lots of action points. I would rather run. Yeah, of course, they noticed me. You can see that they already start chomping me. Yeah, this is another unit. So I can assume that more guys are coming, but they're already exposed. Oh, the light infantry has like no range. You can see. Commandos have much better range. Nice. And they get killed off. Now I can heal the captain. Ah, it was a good thing not to move. Now, since I do believe that these guys won't, I won't keep them after the mission, I want to start using commandos to do the killing. Because they're already leveled up and I want to level them up even more, as much as I can. Okay. Let's try again. I still need to scout this area. Okay, no problem, it's just orcs. You're dumb. What? Okay, what might have happened now, because I didn't touch anything, or maybe I did, but I don't think I did, is that those guys actually lost the morale from all the fighting and waiting and from being wounded, and they run. They can do that. Yeah, they don't really have that much morale. Get back there. I think if it drops like under 20, you will lose control over them. Let me see what time it is. Okay. Yeah. I'll need to wrap it up soon.
Contact.
Yeah, now they saw me. I think they even saw me before, but they wanted me to come close. For 23, 24 years old game, the AI is quite sneaky. And I hope there's more of them just waiting for me to come up alone from the woods. Actually, I think somewhere here is a Magotar, which is a flying unit standing on the ground. What? Oh, damn. The morale is really a problem. Even the commandos are losing it. I think this doesn't really happen on the rookie difficulty. Yeah, there it is. This guy means business. He's strong, has a lot of action points. He's gonna attack me even though that I have just discovered him. Yeah, cool. This is really bad. You know? When they kill someone, they get some morale back. they're luckily squishy, and they've luckily missed their first shot. Okay, I have to get back. That's the problem, if you just keep them on one spot, they will lose the morale. And eventually run. Okay, so I killed the Mogotar, but I haven't discovered anyone. But yeah, I have to start moving with them. I have the commandos. They serve a discount Captain Alexander, but I don't want them in harm's way. But now I'm not that afraid to move without them, and as the Rangers are good scouting in it. Yeah, there's the river. There is the river, and there will be a unit of light infantry that will be in trouble. We'll see why. I'll try to scout a bit. Yeah, let's just use the light infantry as tanks. The trees, those scattered trees, they're really problematic because there just could be guys just behind the trees. The Rangers are not a very good option to scouting because they have nice range, but not many action points. If I step out of the forest right next to an enemy unit, I might not be able to get away in one piece. Yeah, okay. I'm in a half of the map. Let's move carefully. Okay. There is the light infantry, and there are the orcs. Now, this light infantry has a problem. They don't care that I didn't have the turn to move them. And you can see what happens when they reach you. There's 15 of them left alive, 24 wounded, and if I heal them up, I will keep like one third of the original force. So, basically done. I might heal them. Oh, come on.
Waiting.
I probably won't survive this. Well, yeah, that's how it goes. That's what happens when they find you. Oh, I think they were healing. I like it. Yeah, they were healing. They used the turn to heal before they tried to get to me.
Perceiving.
I think that when more than a half of them is wounded, they will always heal only half of the wounded guys. So if
waiting.
No, they will. I don't really remember how it works, but they don't heal up in one level, in one turn, if they're badly damaged. Cool. Now, let's wait. And, yeah. Let's use those guys. As a meat shield. They're nothing else now. They have almost no value for military strength because it's a light infantry that has poor attack anyway from the get-go, and it's just 39 of them. So basically, the power is 39% of the original power of the 100 soldiers. You could see how they went around, automatically went around the stone. Because the stone is obstacle, and it would take more action points to go through it than if they go around it. There is the... I don't actually remember what's it called in English. The place where you can cross the river. It's not the bridge. Now, I'm sure there are more orcs around here. Probably even in the forest. Maybe not. It was those that attacked me from the forest. I remember there were wolves. Yeah, there they are. A great situation. And now it's even less of them. I'm gonna heal them.
Yes. Waiting.
Yes. And we're back. So, it's actually a second day.
Perceiving.
I wanted to keep those light infantry here because they don't really have much use now, as they're really 27% of their initial strength. But I want to keep them there as blockers, and I want to keep those guys alive. So if there's more units in this forest, they can't just pour in and surprise me. That's exactly how I wanted it. Well, actually, I can kill them off. That's nice. So far, so good. So let's use those poor souls as scouts. Not that far. And I know that there is a swamp. It's more difficult to move around in the swamp. There are roads that I will probably want to use.
Yes.
The commandos have more action points, so I want to move them first. I want to have Alexander nicely hidden between the units, if possible. I'm gonna try always to do the same with artillery units, because they can't attack directly in front of them, and the enemy obviously prioritizes them as a target.
Perceiving.
Cool.
Perceiving.
I want to get out of the forest so I can see a bit.
Problems.
I should really.
Yeah.
Wait, where are my rangers? I forgot about those poor guys. I would totally leave them behind.
Waiting. Perceiving. Waiting.
Now I hope I'm not followed.
Problems. Waiting.
Yeah, there is the road. There's also more open space around the road. Oh, great. Now we're in trouble.
Waiting.
Did they see me? They didn't see me. The orcs actually have a very poor range of sight. they can only see like four blocks ahead, I think. That's why I sometimes shoot at them to gain their attention, because then they have to spend more action points actually moving. Okay, so I'll wait here to gain some sandbags, and I will use those guys to bait them. Even though they also have poor sight, now they should see me. So I'll go back. I'll try to wait, because they will disappear now. I'll try to wait to get some counterattacks. Hopefully, yeah. Because they moved and lost all their cover. So I can finish them off. That was the first group. Great. In a situation like this, I usually start with the rearmost units, so I wouldn't start up with commandos shooting on short range and then finding out that I don't have enough range and I would be wasting those points while the front units would be already be getting chopped up.
Proceeding.
Yeah, no, here you can see that the useless light infantry can't even reach them.
Proceeding.
Yeah, I don't have to keep them alive. Even though I should have killed them with commandos to gain a little bit more experience. I will wait a few rounds and now I'll scout around here. Even though the light infantry is a really bad unit for scouting, I am using it. Oh, I need to move.
Yes. Yes. Proceeding.
Oh. Yes. I need to get moving.
Proceeding.
The units are losing morale.
Yes.
Apparently, they're using morale faster when they're dug in. Probably get bored. I hope those guys won't run into some troubles. Yeah, let's use them as meat shield. I'm using a lot of rounds, but it doesn't really matter in this game. And it's worth it to be
perceiving.
Packed into a group. Oh, okay, this is not the right road. I need to get up here. So, yeah, I'll just cross the swamp.
Yeah. Proceeding.
Yeah, almost finished.
Proceeding.
I just need to get to the destination. I might have left some friendly units here, but it would be, I think, light infantry at best. You can see that in the mud I don't really have any range. Now, I will move a bit, but in those trees there will be some ambush, I think.
Waiting.
So.
Waiting.
I want to be careful. And if possible, then bait them out of the trees. Okay, this looks clear to me. Check this side. Even a little bit further. Okay. Wait around. Now I have to move. I think that standing in the mud is not really good for their morale.
Waiting.
And I don't want to get routed into enemy units. That would mean insta-death. Yeah, let's use the one of the last saves here. I think it's not being covered using the saves in the hard mode. On the rookie, you don't really need it. I think that on the rookie difficulty, you won't, your morale won't decrease on its own. There are actually enemy units that are decreasing the morale, that's really annoying. But I don't think it ever happened to me that unit that was standing somewhere for a long time just suddenly rotated by on its own. So that's the difference from the higher difficulty, and it will cause me some problems.
Waiting.
Because I like to wait for the enemy and bait him with the scouts. However, it will force me into more aggressive action, and it will hopefully provide for not as boring footage. I don't want to make this game look too boring. It gets repetitive, it's a game from 90s. Oh yeah, there are some additional units right at the base, waiting for us. I don't know if they will continue with us. I don't remember. We shall see. But now we're basically safe.
Waiting.
Now we can use all our movement points. I know that in the moment when Captain Alexander will step on the platform on one of the star squares, I will win the game, so I think I will. I want to move all my units on the tiles before moving him. Yeah. This is really nice. However, I am not getting tanks anytime soon. The only motorized unit that I will have will be a Humvee vehicle. It's used as a scout, and that's actually the best scout in the game. Has a lot of action points, huge sight, and it can shoot. I can't really say it can defend itself. Later on, when it's upgraded, it can fight off one or two units of orcs or the cow orcs, the upgraded versions, up armored versions of orcs. Okay, so that's it. We went through all the map, collected some units. Hopefully we will keep some of them, hopefully the commandos, because they're already experienced. And let's finish the game. So, mission accomplished. I killed 28 dark side units. It's funny, in the intro, in the international, in the English version intro, the other side is called Forces of Darkness. In the game itself, it's called Dark Side. In the Czech version, it's called Other Side. I actually like the Other Side more, because Dark Side is obvious, Other Side, it's more enigmatic, it's still indicates that we don't know who they are. They're just the guys on the other side, and we fear them. Right, there might be some video. I hope it's recording. Yeah, I would be soiling my underwear being alone.
Good news. Our government has decided to join the Alliance. The loss of experienced men has devastated our ranks. To make matters worse, we have no replacements, and we still know very little about our enemy. Because of frequent communication failures, the Alliance prefers commanders who are capable of operating independently. This is why you have been selected for this mission. Headquarters is unable to assign reinforcements. The enemy squads you will encounter are scattered, so we have a unique opportunity to gain our first victory. Good luck. The first victory.
Nice. Okay, so this actually is what the other view of the game looks like. HQ has sent us reinforcements, not many, but they're all we can spare at the moment. We have been entrusted with some special commando and ranger units. They will be a great help, but the forces of darkness, called forces of darkness here, are fearsome enemy, and a great effort will be needed to even hold our ground. Yeah, that for sure will be. Now, here you can see the map. It's a little bit different from the Czech version, this is our only territory that we hold. And some details on the map. And those are the areas that we can actually attack. But we can't attack them now. Oh, we can. Yeah, we could. But I'm not gonna do that. No, cancel. First, I want to look around and maybe do something with the units. We have some money, very little, because we are playing on hard. First things first, let's save the game. Always like the sound of the keyboard. We can adjust the volume here, but I think it's okay now. Quick help on. Alright, now, this is some statistics. Yeah, we haven't lost anything. Yeah, let's see. This is our units, unit management. Let's see what we've got. So yeah, we have commandos that are level 5. I think those are the guys that we found. Light infantry, level 1. Experience 30, experience 3. This might be the guys that we found, I don't know. Probably not, because the rangers leveled up, and so these are another rangers. So it was like I thought. The commandos that didn't have any markings on the side of their bars were the only ones that we kept, but it's very good. This is really, really important that they're already on level 5. And those commandos will have just 3 attacks, not 4. And the hammer. We can switch to this view, so we can see the picture. It's a nice dish. I don't know if it's supposed to be radar or a light. Probably radar. Looks like radar. So commandos. Rangers. Rangers have a lot of action points. Light infantry, absolutely useless. I don't want to use them at all, preferably. We can change them. We can buy new units. Here is the interface that is pretty confusing because it looks almost the same. If your units are damaged, if some of the guys get killed, you can buy additional to fill up the ranks. And here you can buy units. Mortar infantry will be very important. They're also very expensive, they cost 110. I don't even have money for them now. But it's our first artillery, and artillery is very important here. I won't be needing more than one hammer. It's waste. It's a waste of slot also. I can buy some additional units. I don't really remember but I think I can buy like two or three more, and then it will be maximum I can like handle it right now. Yeah, commanders cost 85. It's also quite high. Light infantry costs 40. They're relatively cheap. They're also relatively useless. Now, I'm actually considering using the heavy infantry as well. It's basically light infantry, just a little bit better, and it has greater capability of attacking heavy units. But the range is just 6. Well, the commandos have range 6 as well. I don't know if the range gets better. Let me see. Those are the upgraded. No, range 6. So range doesn't get upgraded with leveling up. Maybe I will buy heavy infantry because they're not that expensive. I can actually upgrade the light infantry into another units, but it does cost same money as if I would be buying them. When I played with sort of money cheat, that's possible, obviously not gonna do that, I upgraded all of the units into commandos and used just commandos because I think they're the best, most versatile. They can take on heavy units, they have a lot of experience points, and also, very importantly, they have a lot more attacks, which compensates for missed shots. Well, let's look at other panels. Here is I can divide the units into groups, and later on I can buy commanders. They will show up after a few rounds. In this phase you also use rounds or turns, and then you can buy a commander, assign him to a unit, and he will give a nice bonus to the unit. And if they're part of a squad, then the whole squad gets a bonus as well. So, but right now they don't have any bonus, even though they are assigned to a unit, because I don't have any commander. Right here we have research. Here I decide. I have some topics I can research, basically research about the races, some global researches about magic, and yeah, I will be researching new weapons, new armor, and even new units. Most of the units you get at the beginning of this level, but sometimes you can just develop your units. The problem is that in this panel with this factory picture, here is your income. Now, I'm controlling one area, and that area provides 12 money, 12 gold or something. But it provides it only for 10 rounds, 10 turns, and then no more money. So the income is limited. And if that was so, basically, I can buy like from the whole from all the income I can get from this area, I can buy one unit of commandos and one unit of light infantry. Not much. And everything costs money. If I research an upgrade, I have to buy it and apply it to the unit. So everything is expensive, you don't have money, and it's very difficult to make the money. When you conquer new lands, there will be like, I think, 5 areas here. You will then, when you control it, you will then get money out of it. But also just for a limited time. So you really need to think about your investments. And you need not to lose any units, preferably not even single soldiers, because everything costs money. Yeah, and to make the matters worse, I think it's important to research the orcs, because that will lead into research of some UND vest, some basic flak vest, flak jacket, as a basic armor for infantry. And yeah, you want that. So I started the research, and every turn I will assign some research points into it. The problem is I need to fund the research, and I make that by dividing the income into research and money. So if I put 4 points into research, I will be researching, but I won't get any money. All the money I would get will be wasted into the research. So yeah, it's very difficult to manage the economy and stay afloat. I hope I will be able to do it. I hope I will be able to finish the game like this. Okay. I will assign 2 points of research. Basically won't get anything, but the research is important as well. Yeah, this is the information I know about everything that I have. I have saved the game. If I will be just pressing the turn, the enemy will eventually attack me. I think I want to do that, because when they are attacking you, they are higher level and you get more experiences for defending. I want to try that, but not in this episode, it will be next time. Yeah, I think I will actually wrap it up here. We finished the first map and took a look at this interface. I'll save it. And I'll see you guys next time. So, bye.